Good morning, everyone. Good morning, and welcome to our 13th day of Bible Boot Camp. Wow, I've got to tell you something. Today was quite an experience waking up. Not just getting up on time, but getting up and having an asthma attack, and also just the computers not working. Almost lost it this morning. But God was able to put everything together. And so, yes, we are here. We are live. We are direct. And one of the things we want you to know is that God will live out his purpose in all of us. Why are we here? We are here simply because God wants to direct us in a path that's going to glorify him and him alone. In this, we want to welcome you to our 13th day of Bible Boot Camp. Wake up and stretch your spiritual muscles. Our theme for December, our theme for the whole month, is simply born to deliver. And I believe that each one of us were born to deliver. I believe that each one of us, we were made for a reason. That reason, we believe, is to glorify God. But do you know your purpose? And so today we pray and hope that each one of us will come to an understanding of what our purpose is when it comes to living out our life for Jesus Christ. Hey, let's pray together. Father, we come before you thanking you for all that you've done. We thank you for life and for strength and the very opportunity of prayer and praise. But today, Lord, we put our hands in your hands. And today, we follow you because we want to live out our purpose. So we're asking that you continue to rest and abide with us and be with us today. And Lord, I'm also asking that whatever is said and done will be pleasing to you today. In Jesus' name, amen. And so again, we want to thank you. Thank you for joining us. Hey, the Christmas season is upon us. And since the Christmas season is upon us, we just want to acknowledge where great gifts come from. And it does come from God. We're going to ask you also to take some time out throughout the week to share with others about this special ministry. This ministry which we believe is reaching so many others. Receiving calls that there are individuals watching from India. There's individuals watching from all over, especially on our rebroadcast. So you know that you're able to watch the rebroadcast on PastorPaulGraham.org or PastorPaulGraham.com. And you can watch the rest of the rebroadcast or other sermons at that. In this, I wanted to just say to each one of you that the end of the week is here. We are at a place in our walk where we don't have to think about the rest of the week. We don't have to worry about the bills. We don't have to worry about all these things. It is the Sabbath. And for those who are joining us who may have not had the opportunity of worshiping on the Sabbath or observing the Sabbath, we as a people really believe, if we're Bible-believing people, not a religion, but a Bible-believing people, that the Word of God does tell us to remember the Sabbath day, to keep it holy. In 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it, thou shalt not do any work, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, nor thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that's within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made the heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is. And he rested on the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day, and he hallowed it. And do you know that the Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath, which means that because this day, this seventh day, this last day of the week was made for us, it's for us to enjoy it, but enjoy it in him. So today, I want to welcome you not only to a Bible Boot Camp, but to a wonderful Sabbath. I just want to share a special song with you, a song that says, "O God of mine, O God of mine," is an ownership of who God is in our lives. And I love this song simply because it talks about a person embracing Christ. You want to know about your purpose? You want to know what your purpose is all about? First try embracing Christ. Listen to this beautiful song called "O God of Mine."
O God of mine, I'll have no idols. O God of mine, come lead the way. O God of mine, I'm greatly humbled. This sinner's heart, you came to save. God of mine, through storm and trial. Oh God of mine, through death and grave. Oh God of mine, in resurrection, your scars display, my soul's idols. Oh God of mine, come lead the way. Oh God of mine, I'm greatly humbled. This sinner's heart, you came to save. This sinner's heart, you came to save. This sinner's heart, you came to save.
Wow, this sinner's heart, he came to save. That was Jesus' purpose. And as we go into his word today, this day, I want you to know that we're going to be talking about what was Jesus' purpose here? And we've learned already in this song that one of his purpose is to save us as sinners. You know, I know we talked about this maybe a week and a half ago, but I want to ask you a question for our chat room today before we play our commercial. And in the chat room, I'm going to ask you the question, why do you love Jesus? Just put it down, write it down. Just why do you love Jesus? And share with someone today from the chat room your reason why you love Jesus. Hey, I'm going to ask you that. For me, he came to save this sinner's heart. And as we look at this, take some time out to share with one another, oh, this is why I love him. Some people may say because he first loved me, and some people may say because he saved me, and because he loved me, because he forgave me. Whatever it is, write it down. Proclaim in your writing today, why do you love Jesus? In light of that, I want to share something with you. I want to share with you this commercial that talks about how to get out of the rut that we're in. Many people teach different, believe getting out of our rut in life is other religions or maybe Zen or maybe all these other ways of meditation or what have you. But in this commercial, it gives you a story of a man who falls into a hole. But watch, not just a hole. Maybe issues, maybe problems, maybe depression, whatever it may be. Whatever that hole may be. But look at the way that he comes out of the hole. Remember now, the words of this is very cryptic, so listen. Be blessed.
A man fell in a hole. He fell in a hole and he couldn't get out. A traveler passed by. He told the man to meditate, to purify his mind, and when he reached nirvana, all suffering would cease. The man did as he was told, but he remained in the hole. Another man appeared. He explained that the hole didn't exist, and neither, in fact, did the man. It was all an illusion. The man who did not exist was still stuck in the hole that was not there. Another visitor arrived. He instructed the man to perform good deeds to improve his karma, and though he would still die in the hole, he might be reincarnated as something magnificent. Another man looked down from above. He taught the man to pray 5 times a day facing east and to follow 5 important tenets. If he was faithful, one day, perhaps, the divine would set him free. The man prayed as best he could, but he was losing strength, and in the hole he remained. Another man appeared. There was something different about him. He called down to the man in the hole and asked him if he wanted to be free. This man lowered himself into the earth, into the pit. He took hold of the man and dragged him into the light. And the man in the hole, who could not get himself out, was saved.
In your hole, in your rut, in your stuff, who are you asking to help you out? The only person that can help you out is Jesus. Hey, I wanted to go into this word with you today. But before we go into this word, there's just one more song. Just one more song I want to share with you. A song that says, I want to run to you. A song by Smokey Norfolk. Some others heard it earlier this week. And I want to play it again right before our word. And then we're going to pray together. Hey, listen. When we try to understand our purpose, we find that running to God is where we begin. So maybe there's some stuff in your life that's stopping you from finding your purpose, running to Him. And I give you this piece of advice from this awesome song, which simply says, I want to run to you. Let's run to Him at this time as we look for Him to help us find our purpose.
There's so much that only you
can see, but when you pause and take the time, I know in my heart you'll find a little boy who's scared sometimes, who isn't always strong. No, you see the hurt in me, I feel so all alone. I wanna run to you, I wanna run to you. Ooh. Won't you hold me in your arms and keep me safe from harm? I wanna run to you, find my dreams without you, Lord, to share it with. Tell me, what does it mean? I wanna run to you. Oh, I wanna run to you. Ooh. Oh, hold me in your arms and keep me safe from harm.
Run to you. What a beautiful song. We are just amazed of how when we run to him, he is quick. He's very quick to take us in. So as we're talking about our purpose and being born to deliver this month, I wanted to just share with you this word, a word that ought to help us understand what our purpose may be. And in this, I look at Christ's life. And so today I want to concentrate on Christ's life. What was his purpose? Why was he here? What did he do? What did he accomplish so that we may accomplish it also? So, Father, I ask right now that as we talk about your life, that we'll understand our purpose. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, now that the Christmas season is here, and sometimes we are forgetting about the real reason for Christmas. The real reason for Christmas, as individuals would say, was the birth of Jesus Christ. I would say it was the entry of Christ into this world for our lives. Yes, he had to be born, but the impact was made in the life that he lived. You know, the Bible gives us a clear understanding of the things that Jesus have done. He's healed. He rose people from the dead. He encouraged. He taught. He assembled the people together. But he lived a life that was sinless. But his purpose was not just in living. It was, what directly did he do so that we would be saved? Well, from the Old Testament, it talked about Christ. The Old Testament talks about the very thing that we should be expecting from the man of God. And so in this, we've come to realize that if Christ had a purpose and we ought to follow after his life, then that means we must have a purpose too. I want to take you to a text from the Word. The Word is telling us from Isaiah chapter 53, verse 5. Wow. It says, but he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, we were healed. I look at the text even before that, which simply says, surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. Wow. And so when we look at this, we recognize that he was pierced because of our rebellion. Wow. He was crushed because of our sins. When we look at this, it says upon him is the reason why he was whipped. And then this all happened so that we could be healed. Pierced for our rebellion. It just simply says that, you know, on our quest for our purpose, we're messing up along the way. We're making mistakes along the way. And even before we were born, listen, even before we were born, God had a plan for us to deliver. But even before we were born, God had a plan for him to deliver us. You know, the word is so important because it tells us also that, you know, that Christ had a passion for us. And that passion for us was for us to be saved. I love it when the text says that he was crushed for our iniquities. The chastisement or the punishment for our peace was upon him. So in order for us to have peace, somebody had to be punished. And his purpose was to be punished so that we won't have to be punished. Oh, my goodness. I like what the New Living Translation says. The New Living Translation said, it's because of our rebellion. It's because of our transgressions. It's because of our sins. It's because of our rebellious deeds. It's because of our stuff. Yet, the Word of God tells us, I love this, that he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our sins. He was crushed for our punishment. So what was he here for? He was here so that we could be healed. Wow. We could be healed. His purpose was for us to be healed. What an amazing God. That today we recognize God's purpose in our lives. And God's purpose in our lives is that we may be healed. Maybe there's something you need to be healed from. Maybe there's some stuff that you're going through that's getting in the way of your purpose. Maybe your purpose is not realized because we are not accepting his sacrifice for us. Maybe we don't understand his purpose. So not understanding his purpose, we don't understand ours. But today, we pray that God will help you to find your purpose. Today, on this 13th day, on this 13th installment, on this 13th moment that we have together, I want to pray for you that you find your purpose in him. Today, as you write down your prayer request, we want you to know that God has a purpose for you. And that purpose may have to start also with understanding what his purpose was for us. So, as we get ready for prayer, know this, that he was wounded for us. He was bruised for us. He was punished for us so that we might be healed. If you'd like to send your prayer request to us, or you'd like to just give us a word of encouragement, please send your prayer request to fcmbootcamp@gmail.com. That's fcmbootcamp@gmail.com. Send your prayers, even questions, so we can talk about it today. And before we give you the pick of the day, we want to pray for you. We want to pray for every individual that's on at this very moment. And so as we pray that God is going to do something special in your life. We're going to pray that God is going to allow us to get into the Word, see him more clearer than ever before. And so let's get ready for prayer. let's get ready for prayer. But before we do that, I want to mention two individuals. First of all, I want to thank Abby for her post yesterday in on Facebook concerning, you know, really getting to the deep root of how to get closer to Christ. You know, it's not just about reading your word, but it's really about getting a little deeper than that. And Abby, I really like that. And I think that we are all challenged to having a deeper relationship with God, something that's meaningful. The question was, how do we do it? But it's going to take us being deeper than we've ever been before, living out that life also. And to be honest with you, Abby, one of the real issues about having a deeper meaning or relationship with Christ is really seeking Him out and being truthful with Him and honest with Him so that we may be able to honor the relationship. And to be honest with you, I'm trying to seek out a deeper relationship with Christ too. Though I may feel mine is deep, I always want to go a little bit deeper. Post that question to us in the chat room so we can make it a point of discussion even more. And then I want to say congratulations to Lala James. We worked together in the past on BBC Unplugged. She has been asked to do some motivational speaking in the DC public schools. And so we just want to say holla, or we just want to say congratulations to you. But we also want to pray that God will continue to lead you guys and lead even other individuals as we pray for neighbors, pray for friends, pray for hope, and pray for purpose. Let's pray together. Father, again, we come before you thanking you for life and for strength and the opportunity of prayer and praise this morning. In this time, Lord, we want to just thank you for great fortune, great life, and a great God. Today we come before you simply saying thank you for being an awesome God to us. We pray today for all of the prayer requests that were given, praying for neighbors, praying for individuals who just simply want to thank you. There's others who are asking for housing and physical, mental, emotional, spiritual, and financial healing. Brother Edgar is praying for his co-worker, who they laid to rest their brother and father and uncle. And Brother Edgar, we also want to pray for your mom still. We ask, Lord, in a special way that you continue to lay your hands on individuals who are expecting. We ask you to be with Claudette's co-worker, Davina, in her leadership concerning her school. We also ask in a special way that others who have been asking for clarity and their schoolwork, we're asking for you to help others who are looking for employment. We just want to thank you, Lord, for being a good God. Today we pause and thank you for the Sabbath that you have given to us, that we may find you and seek out our purpose in you today. And today, Lord, we come before you just simply saying thank you. And as we spend this day together, we ask you that we'll recognize that we're not punished because you were punished. We're not chastised because you were chastised. We're not whipped because you were whipped. And we're paused to say thank you for dealing with us, as Edlene says, in our mess. So bless us again and strengthen us and be with us today. All these mercies we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. And so again, I want to thank you for joining us on Bible Boot Camp. We just simply want to say to each one of you, remember that you were born to deliver. You were born for a purpose. God's got you. He's got you. You've got a purpose. And so this is the pick of the day. I want you to share it with others. And the pick of the day simply says, listen closely, it simply says, your life has purpose. Your story is important. Your dreams count. Your voice matters. You were born to make an impact. Come on, everybody, read it with me together. Your life has a purpose. Your story is important. Your dreams count. Your voice matters. You were born to make an impact. And yes, you were born to make an impact. That's the kind of God that we serve. Hey, be blessed today and know that God is in the midst. I want to leave you with a beautiful song by Jonathan Nelson. Remember, you were born to deliver.
Now here's brand new music from the latest single on Jonathan Nelson. It's called Called to Be. Let's hear this new music. Come on, Jonathan.
In the journey of life.